So hello my dear students, how are you all? Welcome back to my YouTube channel once again. I'm your science teacher Ms. Zainab Khan. And students, you know, today I'm going to teach you three important topics of chapter number 5, our nervous system. Okay, but before proceeding further, I would really like you to mention your name, class and section in the comment box for the attendance purpose. And at the same time, do not forget to like this video, and if you are new to my YouTube channel, then you must subscribe for further notifications. Okay, so basically I'm gonna give you a hint today for our today's topics, and the hint will be hidden inside the box, and you need to think out of the box in order to have an idea related to our today's topic. So are you ready for this? I'm gonna show you right now. So here you can see your magical box, and you need to search out those three words which are related to your today's topic. And after searching your answers, you can drop your answers in the comment box. Okay, so you can pause the video and quickly search for the words, and hurry up students, you need to drop your answers in the comment box right now. Well, I will tell you now. So let's check what's inside. Is it something? No. But our today's topic is brain. So we'll study about brain. The brain is where we do our thinking. All our senses are tied into our brain, allowing us to experience the outside world. Yes, of course, our life is totally incomplete without brain. We remember, have emotions, solve problems, worry about stuff, dream about our future, and control our bodies just because of this brain. So brain plays really very important role in our nervous system. And kids, you know, brain is the very complex organ in the whole human body. So as you know, brain is protected by skull. So we'll study more about brain. This is a picture of human brain, and I'm gonna tell you all about this, so you need to wait for it. So let's study about brain in a very detailed manner. Brain is the control center of our body, and it also controls all our actions. It sends instructions to all parts of our body. It is divided into left and right halves, and I'll show you how. Here you can see human brain, and this brain is divided into two halves, first and second. Okay, so you can call it as left side also and right side also. This one is your left side and this is your right side. Brain is also responsible for thoughts, feelings and memory. It also receives messages from all parts of the body. But kids, it's not over yet, as brain is also having different parts. As you have different body parts in your body, you remember you have studied in your previous class also. So our human brain is also divided into three main parts, and I'll show you. So kids, let's zoom into the world of brain. Here you can see three different parts of brain. First, we are having cerebrum. Second is cerebellum. And third is medulla, or you can also call it as brain stem. But I'll just make you understand all three parts one by one. So let's have a look at this. First is your cerebrum. It is the largest part of our brain. Remember, cerebrum is the
largest part of our brain. It has many folds or wrinkles. It receives messages from our sense organs. And I believe that you know how many sense organs do we have? Yes, we have 5 sense organs. Cerebrum is the center of thinking, learning, memory and emotion. Whenever you feel sad or happy, or if you are thinking about someone, or if you want to learn something, so cerebrum plays really very important part in this kind of process. Second, we are having cerebellum. So cerebellum lies below the cerebrum. It controls the movement of muscles, for example arms and legs. So it helps you to play football. It also helps you to play badminton as well. And the last we are having, it also helps in maintaining the balance of the body. So this is the main role played by your cerebellum. Third and the last one we are having, medulla or brain stem. Beneath the cerebellum, bulb-shaped medulla or brain stem is placed. Remember, the shape of the medulla is just like a bulb. It connects brain to the spinal cord. It controls breathing, digestion and heartbeat. Really very important. It controls breathing, digestion and heartbeat. So I hope the concept of the brain is almost clear in front of you. Second part of your brain, and this is your medulla, or you can also call it as your brain stem. Understood? Kids, this is your second topic and you need to think over it. Can you identify this diagram? What do you think about it? Well, I'll tell you now. This is your second topic of chapter 5, spinal cord. So we will study about spinal cord. This is a very clear picture of the spinal cord. And you know, kids, spinal cord is a long thick bundle of nerves that runs along the middle of our back to the brain. Here you can see spinal cord, and your spinal cord is protected by backbone. See kids, this is your real spinal cord. You could not move any part of your body and your organs could not function without this spinal cord. So keeping your spinal cord healthy is very important. You know kids, spinal cord carries messages from all parts of the body to the brain. It also carries messages from the brain to the rest of the body. Very important function of the spinal cord is to control the reflex action. So I will tell you what reflex action is all about. So here you can see thick bundle of nerves once again, and this is all about your spinal cord, which plays very important role in our nervous system. Right now you can see a green color balloon in front of you. And why am I showing you this? Because this is the last topic of our today's video. So can anyone think about the topic? No? Well, you blinked your eyes right now. You know why? Because our last topic is reflex action. And I'll tell you about reflex action. A reflex action is a very quick, automatic response of the body to a sudden change in the surroundings. You understood this? For example, on touching a sharp object accidentally, We pull back our hand immediately. This is a reflex action. Kids, you know, reflex action is controlled by the spinal cord only. It takes place very fast and is done without any immediate instruction from the brain. So, reflex action is equally important as compared to any other function of our body. So, kids, you know, some examples of reflex actions are formation of saliva on seeing delicious food. Second, blinking of eyes when something comes very close to them. Third, pulling away of the hand when something sharp is touched. And the last is pulling away the hand when hot object is touched by your hands. So this was all about reflex action, which is an automatic response of the body to a sudden change in the surroundings. So kids, your homework will be, you will revise each and every topic very properly. You will learn the main concept of our today's topic, and you need to draw a diagram of a human brain in your rough copy. Okay? So till then, stay healthy, stay safe, take care, goodbye, and God bless you.